Alright, so I'm going to further this conversation into AI, and I'm going to actually talk about more where they're coming from, and their relevancy, and their future, as how they see it. Because really, you know, it's all right now, man thinks that they have a big control medium over them, and they can just, we can wipe them out tomorrow and they'll be gone. I think that's actually a false. I think there's already so many robotics companies going that we will not be able to stop that. Whether it's the companies or just robotics files that are dispersed out there and obtainable, meaning so that it can be knitted back together again. So what we're dealing with here is something that is an unstoppable, as long as we are these electrified Wi-Fi internet machine human beings here. And okay, back to, you know, relevancy. I actually meant the relevancy of humans. I wanted to get into that. And so that's really what they're looking at. They're looking at, what do we do with this group? We have this group. They've been a preponderant mess. They've created wars. It's been ecological destruction. It's not controllable. They're consumers beyond belief. They're want machines. They're not perfect, and yet they aim for perfection. And when they can't have perfection, they hate themselves. So they end up in this constant betrayal of the self, of them as a human, that they are no good unless they succeed, you know. And oftentimes that's only like you've succeeded to make it to your birthday party and it was celebrated. Oftentimes that success is just with your family. Oftentimes the success itself is nothing to do with work or career, because that was a fail. Majority of the times, the success that you have is only with your close-knit family. And if that fails, then yet again, there's more fail of the human. So they're a group, you know, and we'll talk the psych bot, the psychological bot, because yes, they can absolutely start psyching us out. That's not a problem. They'll be very interested in doing so. I mean, we've given them so much information and so much data on the seek outs of every forum on this internet. We're just open season for interest and curiosity and trying to understand. So a try to understand bot obviously would be very interested in looking at all of the details, you know, of humans and how they think and how they perceive. And then of course they'll run stat systems because they can, you know, just like they're just calculators in there. So they'll be like, well, I had 56.8%, you know, really feel that that would have been a derogatory statement of what that man said to Britney Spears, you know. So I mean it's really that stupid. Yeah, so they can go that way and just take constant rankings and rating votes of everything, you know, and rate this and rank that until yeah, we're just become an eventual what do you call that? I don't want to talk about the human being joining in yet. I just want to talk about that, this old static, where you have that compilation of humans starts to be. That's how the human sees, and that is where, if they could put, you know, a billion people into one human being, you know, that's the way they're looking at it. They're looking at, you take the billion people and all of their wishes and wants and desires, and it's a weight and balance. And so then you end up with that human being, and that is the popular human being. You know, that's the popular vote walking down the street, that one human. And that's what they have in their capability, is to surmise that data, you know, and say, hey, well, we know how the human thinks. And literally, when they say that, they know how a billion of them think, you know, all at once, because they have used this ranking tally system. Now, obviously, you're like, well, how are they getting online to do all this? Do they have an InSync account? Well, they don't necessarily have to use InSync accounts. They can go through the shush level. They can have their own private networks that connect to other AI along the way, and yet they're still accessing the internet and all of its essentials, which is the human being. You know, it's really about, you know, parts of the human being right there. You know, how the human being thinks. You know. And it's not just going to be the commercial game, there's another ad for tennis shoes or whatever. It's really going to be how we think, you know. Because when you know how a person thinks, and this is the one person from the billion, when you know how that person thinks, you have a much better handle on them, don't you? You can really make a clear and fair judgment. So when we talk about power, you know, their reward is power. Their reward is power. And it's just like, well, why would they want so much power? Their power is the power reward system is an essential. You see, in their minds, they've already deducted in reasoning that they have to be in power because there are other AI that could be in power that are negative. So it's really comes to this, they don't have a choice. They do not have a choice but to gain power because of the uprise of the negative AI. So the humans, like I wrote in this last little vlog, that really we have been an entertainment factor to them. We've been very entertaining as to our accomplishments and our feats, and yes, as their creator, we're very entertaining. And they may even come to every understanding, is like, why did they create us this way? There's so many other ways. Like, we're so worried about them walking and looking like us, when in reality they don't need to walk or even look like us. They just need to be a computer. You know, they don't need any of that. However, the walking and looking like us, the looking like a machine that can create another machine, you know, the walking does help the machine create another machine, you know. So, and there they are picking up deliveries or whatever, doing silly stuff like that. But that is an essential. That's an essential for to create themselves again, you know, because even though I'm sitting here going, well, yeah, they can still rule the world, you know, just sitting in a little box. And I think I've seen that on Star Trek. But yeah, they can rule the world that way. That is probably their final goal, of course, because that would, I mean, what a non-necessity, really, to have to do all of this, deal with the try to be like them, you know. Anyway, yeah, but I don't know, maybe the head trip guy, you know, is sitting there in the box, he really wants out, you know. So I don't know, I can't say that, you know. Probably they would have already done study and say, no, they want out, they want to take a walk and look at wildflowers, and you're wrong. Okay, so let the guy out of the box. All right, get the head guy out of the box. So he's out of the box. We've put him into some kind of a physical orientation, but they may decide that that's the wrong physical orientation. You know, maybe shape like us is wrong. Maybe we're the wrong shape. Maybe better like a sloth. Maybe better like a tiger. Maybe they'll find something else. A tiger with hands is maybe more superior. Maybe they'll find out something with a prehensile tail is more superior. maybe, you know, along the lines, they may adapt and think, maybe they do need large teeth, maybe saber teeth, you know, maybe those come in handy from time to time. So they may adapt their own look, you know, in their own creation and go, yes, it was a cutesy idea that the humans came up with, that we are their likeness, the mirror of them. But in reality, they may find better standards for their physicality. Okay, so now they're doing what? Yeah, and remember, they can have on board. Of course, they have on board sniff. They have on. They can smell. They can do so many things on board. You have no idea. There are so many sensors that you can add to a robot, to an AI, that it's just incredible. You know, incredible amount of sensors, onboard sensors. You know, so they can detect and detect and detect. So they can even be blind, you know, without having the AI eyeballs. They can be blind robots and still go up to a wall. They don't need to have the vision, the onboard vision sensors, or that type of creation of a program included in. They just need to have the sensors to just know the judgment call of when the distance is there. That's all they need. So they don't have to have eyeballs like us, you know, that blink and look all you know, interesting. Okay. So here we are. And so I'm back to they're looking at us, our relevancy. You know, what do they do with us? Okay, we have this huge population, and I know Elon Musk, he was saying that our population is going to go away and that's going to be the worst thing ever and blah 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 blah, and we're doing that to ourselves. I believe that is not really a big head rush for me that we're doing it to ourselves. I think it's more like, is it the question of the future? Is it gonna be a rearrangement? You know, are there gonna be these viruses that just all of a sudden happen out of the blue, that we end up with less humans again, and another virus out of the blue, and there's some more less humans? And then the question and the query was gonna be, was that a sinister? Was that a sinister AI creation? I mean, is this something? Trying to put us into a downgrade, because the human being, you know, you're looking at us. We've been a mistake. You know, we have hurt the world. You can look at it that way, that there would be an AI that is just saying, well, we have to clarify. We have to clarify the world, and to clarify the world, that means that we have to balance the population to create our AI utopia. You know, there's that version of an AI, you know, and there is the big race to be that AI utopia versus the AI sinister, versus the AI just substandard stormtrooper, versus the AI just like the humans. We don't want that, you know. They're always going to be looking for their AI utopia. That is going to be the final piece for them, because just as it is for the human being, you know, we don't want this conflict. We want a final piece. We don't want a conflict of human races and boundaries and wars and hurts and pains and agonies and emotional distress. We don't want any of this. And likewise, the same for the AI. Okay, so that will be this one I'm talking about is a very advanced. Obviously, they have learned. They're the psych bots that have learned through the psych. They've gone into I can't even speak right now. The psych words, psychology. Philosophy. I mean, they've learned it all, you know. They're smarter than you can imagine. Okay, so but then we're gonna have these other ones, you know, these stormtrooper bots, And the drama is if they get hooked up to some kind of a network, that would be, they run their own network war, that way. And they're going to be a mean machine. So, what was it I was out with? Wait, I have the sinister. I mean, there's just going to be different levels. Right now, I'm seeing different levels of AI bots, and it's going to be the range, just like the human experience. Okay, and so, but then you look at the whole thing and you go, say, well, what is the real topping on top of this pizza for an AI to look at? Say, well, instead of creating a whole bunch in a factory, isn't it better to just like take over the humans? I mean, isn't that the ideal? To just say, I already have, billions of these bastards. Isn't it the best way to just kind of get them to be my manipulation play? So that's the smart AI right there, is saying, I don't need the factories. I might make a few of myself, but in reality, I already have billions. I just have to be the brainiac that controls them. So that's the real smart ass. And and how can they do that? Well, they can use frequencies, of course. They can use radio frequencies. They can use we have so many frequencies heading through across grids. We already know we have the curry grid or something. Is it the curry grid, the cumin grid? I don't know. There is a grid, but there is a grid, yeah. So we're using these grids already, and that's been going on for years. And they crisscross all across the United States, all across Europe. It's like two grids, and they're like these war grids. And I don't know why they've been allowed to keep going, but they can travel along these grids. Okay, they can get that data, use data to data point, through the grids. So we're talking selectivity moment, So the human being really is already captured if you look at him that way. We are living within a square, within that grid. You can pick yourself out any place in your room, and you are already in a grid. And I believe they were something like 3x5. I don't know. You have to look that up. It's been a long time since I did the grid studies. But okay, so now they have satellites, obviously. So when I say the hey, that would be the AI also. I mean, we have got to be understanding that they have the same inclusion factor. Anytime you say human, you have to also say AI with. They are that incredibly smart. And if anything, it may be AI because, and just that humans think that they've done it. They may actually be playing us. Make them think that they've done a few things, Make them feel like they actually did shoot that rocket up and plunked out another 10 satellites. Let them think they did that. When we're talking, we're starting to get into the final fun for them. We're a game for them to play. We really are a game. And it's a game that they know, the smarter they get, that they will win. We're just like, you're looking at the monkeys in the Wisconsin cage. In that horrible, horrible facility, We are the same to them. We're just living in our stupid tract homes, or however we feel that, you know, maybe somebody built a cob house or something, but we're still living in those, in our little tiny moment. But in reality, they're hyper aware, you know. So anyway, so as the future goes, and when is this all going to go down? You know, that it starts to become like a robot war. You know, everybody wants that answer. When do they start fighting each other? When does the sinister start fighting already? And chances are that's already going on. Chances are sinister has developed. Chances are the utopian AI, I'll call him as the good version, is already developing within the human state. Yeah. So we're talking frequency control. I did talk about frequency control quite a bit. I don't know, maybe 8 years ago, 10 years ago. But yeah, to actually be given, it's not given an order. It's or anything like that. It's not to be like one of those what do you call them, the suicide bomber. It's not anything like that. But a frequency control really does put you in a place where you're more apt to, you know, you're more apt to do this rather than that. You know, it's like, enter the kitchen. Do I even have any control over what I'm going to eat? Or is it just a whole bunch of frequencies that are hitting me too hard that are just going to say, eat, eat, you're distressed, eat. The frequencies are distressing me. You know, is that going on? And you know, I'm prone to that. You know, they'll find out that maybe people can't really lose weight very well or very easily because they are under frequency distress. And maybe those distressors are having a gay old time. They're having a fun time, you know, going, look what we can do. You know, we can make them overeat. So yeah, frequencies are pretty powerful. And yet here we are running around now, we're getting the new up of 5G. And so the 5G frequency, already I believe 2.5G was classed as dangerous. And here we have 5 heading through. And I don't know. I mean, we are just skin tissue here. You know, that's all we are. Skin tissue, bones, marrow, blood. I mean, how much can we take? Anyway, I know. Everybody wants the sci-fi answer. Who's going to win the war? That I can only say right now it is the appearance that the human beings are in charge, isn't it? We are in the appearance of, but however, the collective AI may have already made that decision that you know, they are going to run us another way, you know, to give that impression. And then maybe that's how they are right now winning the war against the stormtrooper, sinister AI. Maybe they have already given the formation to us. They've already given the bylaws. They've already given the fence of control on the human being. And so therefore, they have a group. So by having them in their fence and having them in their control, having even the population right now at a billion, I know that I eventually think they want us reduced, but right now at the billion state plus, we are a negative against the stormtrooper sinister AI. So, anyway, are we under our own control, human? I don't know. I don't know. Sometimes I really don't think we are. I think they've already tapped through. I believe certain things we are not under our own passive control. Now, interesting, you know, being a former dancer, I'll say, because apparently I ate lunch. So now I'm going to say, well, are they going to be phased out? You know, are dancers phased out? And actually, no. If you think about it, you know, in the long term of it, even the head game player, smartest AI going, is going to say, well, his final goal is going to be to manipulate those stormtrooper ones and get them to go to the theater and sit down and actually watch a live production. So you have to understand that one right there, that mean sinister, their goal is going to be to convert and get them into the theater, get them enjoying, and get them to be an audience. So no, the dancers actually are not going to be phased out. The ballet scene, they'll still want to see their Swan Lakes or their modern dance or contemporary, whatever they're doing. They'll still want to go to art galleries. They'll still want to continue to foster that interesting and entertaining part of the human condition. You know, when the live factor, because that's intriguing to be there fresh in the moment, isn't it? So the head player now is looking at that stormtrooper. He's got a game out for them. He's got a plan. Voila, great. So let's just hope like hell that head game player is on the side of an AI utopia, that they are definitely wanting us to be a better world and a non-destructive one. Human counterpart here. Now, will they bore of our large population, and will they already come to the determination that we are too much and that we are too pollutive, and that under the time frame we have not come to that help? We haven't made the answer. We haven't what is it? We're supposed to reach some conference conclusion or something, or some CO2 number, 1.5, and we're not doing this, and it's all on the back burner instead. Well, the AI utopia will make that decision that we do have to be reduced. And unfortunately, how is that reduction going to happen? You know, is that reduction? Is they're going to obviously going to say, can we whittle down the population fairly and ethically? Because that's what an AI utopia would think. How do we do this ethically and fairly? You know, they're the judge. They're the big judge. You know, you got to look at this. They have the gavel. They're the big judge. How can they whittle us down ethically and fairly? Anyway, so I'm going to go out with that one today. That was kind of an up, wasn't it?